We are so sorry. We are going to record the rest of our presentation for today. We are having technical difficulties due to the Wi-Fi at a hospital. So patients all over, hospital providers use the internet, and so sometimes that internet can come in and out, and so it's not allowing us to do the live feed at this time. So you're not going to miss anything. We're just going to record the rest of the presentation, and so hopefully when you guys log back in, you'll be able to see the whole thing. So we're going to pick up. We were left off with talking about vital signs, and Ms. Annika is going to step us through what happens when we get our vital signs taken and what they are.
So, Ms. Tess is going to act as our patient. So, we're going to turn on our vitals machine. We hear a lovely little ding. I'm going to show you how we check with a temporal thermometer first. So, we're going to go across the forehead, over the temporal artery, and that gives us our thing. And then each time we use it, we have a cover on here, and that helps us to prevent the spread of infection. So every patient gets their own cover, and then we throw it away after we're done. Next, what we're going to do is check our pulse ox. So this little clip is like a little alligator or shark mouth, and it goes right onto your finger.
It's super soft. We call it like a pillow for your finger.
Yep. It has a red light. If Ms. Tess turns her hand, there's a red light inside. So I'll always tell you to try to touch the red light, and then give it just a moment. It'll show you your oxygen level. We want you above 94%. So Ms. Tess is 99%.
Now Tess has got
perfect.
You got a lot of oxygen.
Yes, I do.
That's good.
And
oh,
then
now I'm at 100.
Her heart rate. So depending on how old you are is how we determine whether or not you have an appropriate heart rate for your age. So babies have a much faster heart rate than Ms. Erin and I or Ms. Tess does. So for an adult like Tess or I, we want it between 60 and 100. So Ms. Tess is perfect. The next vital sign we take is your blood pressure. So depending on how big you are or how old you are is the cuff we use. So we have a little green one for kiddos. It has a super cute train and steamboat on it. Or for Ms. Tess, who's an adult, we have our blue cuff. So normally I would ask Ms. Tess to take her jacket off because that interferes with your blood pressure, but we'll just leave it on for now because it's super cold today. So this will go on Ms. Tess's arm, and it has a marker that shows you your artery index marker, and so you want that to go over the artery on the arm and then wrap around, and it Velcros on. And then we'll hit our blood pressure start button, and you'll hear it inflate. So your cuff is inflating kind of like a balloon.
I tell kids, it just gives your arm a hug. It doesn't hurt.
So you have to hold really still while it's doing your blood pressure. If you're moving around like a chicken, it'll show your blood pressure really, really high just because it's like, I don't really know what's happening here.
Or it'll think it's a chicken.
And it won't read at all.
No, we wouldn't want that to happen.
So it inflated first. And then it's going to deflate, which is why you see these numbers going down, down, down until it'll give us our blood pressure. So 119 over 75 is perfect for an adult like Ms. Tess. Depending, again, on how old you are will be what tells us if it's a normal blood pressure or not. And then this red number right here, it says MAP, but it's not like Dora the Explorer's map that shows her where to go.
Oh.
It means mean arterial pressure. So we want your mean arterial pressure to be above 65. That tells us that your heart, which is kind of like your pump, is perfusing blood to all of your really important organs, like your liver, kidneys, all of that fun stuff. So once we're done with this, we'll take off our light, we'll take off our blood pressure cuff, and those are our vital signs. So we'll put how many times you're breathing in a minute, which is part of your vital sign set. So if you have asthma or are having trouble breathing, you might be breathing much faster than normal. And that says to me, something is going on here. And then how you're getting your oxygen. So this shows me all the options of how I can help people breathe better. So if you're having a hard time breathing, I might give you some oxygen. For Ms. Tess, she's on room air, so we're going to pick room air. And then where we did her blood pressure cuff, which was her right upper arm.
Now, are you entering all that into the medical record chart when you're doing that?
Yes. So we can do it in a couple of ways. On this machine, if I put it all on here and click save, it'll transfer over to your electronic medical record, or I can have my laptop with me and I can chart it that way.
So I guess it's important if you're wanting to go into healthcare that computer skills is very necessary, right?
It is.
So studying, taking a computer class, learning about electronic medical records charts, that would all be very important if you wanted to go into healthcare.
Correct. And that's actually, if you want to become a nurse, that's part of your curriculum in nursing school, is to go through a computer class. That way you have the basic understanding. Or if you want to be like Ms. Chappelle, who we met earlier, she's a consumer access specialist, she should probably go through a computer class too. And then no matter what position you're in, if you come work in the hospital and you have to use a computer, we'll send you to a computer class that teaches you about the electronic medical record and how to do your job the best way that you can. So you'll get all that information in school, and it's really important to understand computers at least a little bit if you want to be a nurse. And we'll help you along the way. So the next part of our triage is asking you whether or not you have allergies. Allergies are really important to know because we want to know what's safe to give you and what's not. So we have two bands. The first one says allergy, which tells everybody, hey, they have an allergy to something. We need to find out what it is. That way we can keep them safe. And the second one says no known allergies, which means we don't have any allergies that we know of, but we still need to be careful and watch what we give you.
Miss Annika, what are some signs or symptoms if I did have an allergy? What would my body be doing?
So everybody's allergy is a little bit different. Some of the things you might experience are itching or hives, which look like big red bumps on your skin, a rash, swelling. So sometimes your lips might swell, your eyes might swell, or you might have itching in your throat. And if you have those things on your face or itching in your throat, it's really, really important that you tell an adult immediately. We want to make sure that our allergy doesn't progress into something more serious like anaphylaxis, which means your throat closes and you can't breathe anymore. So we want to avoid those things. So I know Ms. Tess has no allergies, so I'm going to give Ms. Tess a no allergy band. And you're going to wear your allergy band and your name band the whole time you're in the emergency room. That way everybody knows who you are and what allergies you have.
So after you do all of that and you, the doctors say that it's that you have to stay in the emergency room, would you then leave the triage?
Yep. So after we're done triaging you, we would move you into a patient room. And in your patient room, you get a nice big stretcher or a big comfy chair just like Ms. Tess is in. And that's where you'll sit for us to continue doing your exam.
Great. And so maybe in future videos, we'll be able to see what happens next in the emergency room.
Absolutely. So in our next video, we're going to take you into a patient room and we're going to give you an example of what might happen when you're here with us.
So remember, everyone, please fill out the survey on your screen when you see this recording so that you can be entered in to win our beautiful Thank You Advent Health. A nice prize for your classroom that has all kinds of great information that you can do for further lessons and fun things to do to learn more about healthcare. Thank you to everyone today. Thank you, Chris. Thank you, Annika. Thank you, Tess. And Advent Health for this great presentation. We look forward to seeing you next Friday. More details to come.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
And remember, every student at the bottom of the link, every student, go ahead and fill out that survey for that chance to win those awesome prizes. Thank you again. Signing out.